Welcome back to CAD/CAM tutorial. Today we are going to create a screwdriver assembly in SOLIDWORKS, and this both the parts we will create in SOLIDWORKS assembly. So let's see how to make this one with the help of 2D drawing. I hope you like it. Now here let's start to create a slot head screw in SOLIDWORKS assembly interface. So let's open file, new, and here I'll select assembly. Okay. Now here we are going to create a screwdriver assembly. So let me change background plain white, even though I'll change the image quality also, keep higher, don't cross red line, otherwise your file size become too high. Okay, now this is your screwdriver. So first we will create this handle. This handle length is 100 millimeter and diameter is 28 millimeter. Okay, then there is one cutout, this slot, this you will see this slots 75 millimeter long, and the radius of this slot is 6 millimeter, and six number of slots here you will see in this drawing. Then we will make one hole. So inside there is a hole, and you will see this screw length diameter is 7 millimeter and hole length is 50 millimeter. So this one we will make in one shot. Now here what we will do, we will select here new part. First do one thing, save your this part, go to the folder and click one folder, screwdriver. Now here select this is slot head screwdriver or slot tip screwdriver. Save. Now we will create our first part. So you have to choose new part. Once we select new part, it will ask you, even though if you gently press double key two times, and you are able to change the name of this part. So this one we will select handle, enter. Now here we change the name. Now here this green mark asking you choose your plane. So here we will select front plane. Once you select front plane, we entered in the C sketch dimensions. So I'll choose normal circle 28 millimeter, enter. See isometric view, go to features and select extruded boss base, and here we length keep end condition blind, and this is going in one direction, so the length we will keep 100 millimeter. Now see. Okay, let me select the back surface sketch. Now here we want to create a slots circle normal view, and let me draw once. Okay, start from here, 6 millimeter, enter. Isometric view, go to feature and choose your command extruded cut, and here keep end condition blind. See, this is moving in correct direction, 75 millimeter long. Okay, now see the slot is created. Now what we will do, we will select here circular pattern. First we have to choose fillet, so I'll select this one simply, and here parameters we have to select the circular face. So let's choose this one. You will see here six number of patterns, equal spacing, this is important, and 360 degree. See, a sketch. Now here we want to make a slot hole, so this is 7 millimeter, enter, feature and extruded cut, and we want to make a depth 50 millimeter according to drawing. Okay, see, Now here this is the our main drawing. So what else balance? There are small radius, 1.5 millimeter, 1 millimeter. If you saw this slot radius 2.5 millimeter, here it is written. Okay, and there is one ellipse. See this ellipse cut 8 by 21 millimeter. I'll show you the dimension. Here those dimensions not mentioned, and this corner radius is 10 millimeter. So drop down this menu and first select isometric view, and let me choose. Okay, this is the perfect plane. Right plane, sketch, take the normal view, and here choose ellipse. Smart dimension, let's define. Overall length 21, so this is 10.5 4 millimeter. Okay, now distance from here 1 millimeter, and we will keep this one in center 12.5 millimeter. Now this is still not defined. Do one thing, select these two points, hold shift key, horizontal. See, this is fully defined. Now we will use revolve cut command to cut a, let's make a center line. This is important line for axis of revolution. Isometric view. Now if you go to feature, and you will find one option here, revolve cut. Once you select this one, see here the line already selected by default 360 degree, and keep end condition blind so that it will move from one direction and complete 360 degree. Oh, that's fine. It's time to add fillet. First we will add this big fillet. I'll choose one edge and 10 millimeter. Okay. Fillet 1.5, this edge. Okay. Fillet 1 millimeter. And I'll choose these two edges. Okay. Fillet 2.5 millimeter, and this time we will choose not face, choose edge. All six edges we are going to select 2.5 millimeter. Okay. Now there is one more radius balance, 1 millimeter, and I'll select one edge, and you'll get this option. So the first option, choose first option, right, loop 5 edges, and it will select all the things, and here make 1 millimeter constant fillet, and size is 1 millimeter. Oh, that's fine. So this is the handle is created. This is simple handle. Now exit. The our first part is completed. Let's move second part. So again choose insert part. Double click and change the name like screw, enter. Now it is asking you choose plane from where you are going to start our geometry. So just we want to start from inside, so I'll select inside. Once you select inside, the sketch feature is created. Now let me choose either circle or select inside circle, convert entity. No need to draw the circle. Feature, extruded boss base, and this length 150 millimeter. This is second part, so no need to merge or unmerge things. Okay. Now let's save the drawing first. See this inside circle, this length is 150 millimeter. diameter is same 7 millimeter, that's why we choose. And bottom 10 millimeter we will extrude, and there is one cutout. So this radius 18.5, 5.5, 9 millimeter, this is the distance one. Okay, this is the remaining thing and nothing important. Okay, again I'll select this face sketch, click convert entity, so no need to draw circle. Extruded boss base, and here we will 10 millimeter, but here we will uncheck this merge result so that we will get a two body. See, we have two bodies. If you drop down this menu, and here you will find two bodies, because here we are going to create a tip. So drop down isometric view, let me check right plane sketch normal center line, let me choose 3-point arc, and I'll start with this point to here and like here line, and try to close this geometry, because this is the geometry we are going to cut 9 millimeter. Okay, and distance from this edge 0.5 millimeter, and the same thing the radius 18.5 millimeter. Oh, that's fine. Isometric view, and we want to cut, so simply go to feature, select extruded cut, and here we will keep end condition through all, because we want to cut both sides, so through all both, that's it. Mirror. Now here you have to choose a plane, top plane. In screw panel you have to choose top plane. Here feature to mirror, already we selected this cutout. Oh, that's fine. See, this is created. So this is the our simple screwdriver we created in the SolidWorks assembly interface. Now simply exit. Once you click exit, now let me appoint some material. So click, I'll select handle, go to appearance, in plastic I'll select high gloss plastic, this is too dark, so again I'll edit from here, oh that's look better. Now I'll select the handle screw, and for screw we will choose here metal satin finish steel. Let me open real view. Oh look, this is beautiful. So this is the simple tutorial how to create a screwdriver in SolidWorks assembly interface. I hope you like it. Don't forget to share and like our video, and please subscribe our channel for more video and more projects in SolidWorks. Let me save this one. Now once it save you, it will ask, make sure check all, save all. Now it will ask you, save internally all the parts inside or save externally. So we will choose save externally. See here, it's going to save in two parts. Okay, so click save. Now both the parts separately saved. Thanks for watching.